Have you ever wanted to add a marker or a pin to your map to point out a specific location? I want to walk you through the process of adding a Google map to your Android app to do just that. Let's get started. In this video, I'll be walking you through the adding a map with a marker tutorial found in our docs, which I've linked in the description of this video. To get the code for this tutorial, you'll need to clone or download the Maps SDK for Android samples repository from GitHub. This repo contains tutorials and code snippets found in the Maps SDK for Android documentation pages, as well as a sample application demonstrating all the different features supported by the Maps SDK. Now let's set up your development environment. Go ahead and open Android Studio if you have it already. If not, pause this video and download and install it first. You'll need to add the Google Play Services package to Android Studio. To install that, navigate to Configure, SDK Manager, and in the SDK Tools tab, select Google Play Services and then click OK. Next, you'll need to import the tutorial project in the repository you downloaded earlier. In Android Studio, select Open an Existing Project. Now, go to the location where you saved the samples repository, and you can find the Map with Marker project at this location. And then click Open. To use the sample project, you'll need an API key that is authorized to use the Maps SDK for Android. You can check out the Using API Keys portion of our doc to learn how to get an API key. Once you have your API key created, you'll need to do two things. First, open your project's local.properties file. And next, define a new key called Maps API Key, and as its value, paste your API key. Using the Secrets Gradle plugin, which is included in your app level build.gradle file, when you build your app, Gradle copies the API key and injects it as a variable into the Android manifest. Now let's run the app to see the map displayed. In Android Studio, click the Run menu option and make sure you have a device selected. In my case, I'm going to run the app on a Pixel 4 XL emulator I've created. Clicking on the Run button on Android Studio invokes Gradle to build the app and then runs the app on a device or an emulator. Once Gradle is done building the app, you should see a map with a marker pointing to Sydney in Australia. Now that you have the app running, let's talk about the most important parts of the Map with Marker app so you can build a similar one on your own. First, check the app's AndroidManifest.xml file by taking note of certain elements. There should be a metadata element that declares the version of Google Play Services the app was compiled with. There should also be another metadata element that specifies your API key, which is provided to the Maps SDK and used to authenticate. When you build your app, the Secrets Gradle plugin for Android will make the keys in your local.properties file available as manifest build variables. The full manifest should look like this. It will contain an entry for the application object, a metadata tag for the Google Play Services version, a metadata tag for your API key, and an entry for the activity that will get launched when the application starts. Now let's add a map. Open the activitymaps.xml file, which is the layout file for the launcher activity of the app. This file contains a fragment element, which defines a support map fragment to act as a container for the map and to provide access to the Google Map object. Next, open the maps marker activity file. In the onCreate method of this activity, the activity maps layout file is set as the content view. The support map fragment reference is then obtained by calling support fragment manager.find fragment by ID. Once a reference is obtained, the getMap async method is then used to later obtain a reference to the Google Map object. The activity implements the onMapReady callback interface and overrides the onMapReady method, which is called when the Google Map object is available. In that method, the addMarker method is called on the map object, followed by passing in an instance of a marker options. In this case, the marker will point to Sydney and have the title Marker in Sydney. By default, the Maps SDK for Android displays the content of the info window when the user taps a marker. There's no need to add a click listener for the marker if you're happy to use this default behavior. Congratulations! You've built an Android app that displays a Google Map with a marker to indicate a particular location using the Maps SDK for Android. So how did it go? Feel free to send me a message or leave a comment and let me know. Thanks for watching and happy mapping. My brain is not working right now.